This style transfer workflow is interesting and also simple to use. Let's look at it quickly. Make sure you have updated the comfyUI using this update batch file. Then go to the Browse template and then the template for Flux models. This USO reference image generation is the one we will be looking at. So this is the workflow, and these are the models and files you need to download. Below are the locations to keep the above-mentioned files. The workflow is simple. This is the section where you will be selecting the files after you download. And here is the prompt, then the case sampler, and a caching node, which looks new to me. This node may be new to some of you. There are multiple nodes inside this. I think I should make a separate video on it. So the way it works is the Flux FP8 checkpoint is selected here. A checkpoint here is a safe insert file containing a unit model, clip encoder, and VAE. The main image should be uploaded here. Further, it becomes a condition with a prompt to generate a new image, which then goes to the K-sampler's positive and negative connections. Below is the latent image, an empty canvas where the image will be drawn. And above is the connection for the model, which is also getting influenced by DIT LoRA. This LoRA will generate the image using the inference steps by the larger Flux model. And these nodes here will patch the DIT LoRA and the Flux model. Once that image is loaded here, the LoRA gets influenced by it. This means my generation will adopt the style of the image while maintaining the main subject. So you can upload a style image here and another image here to merge and create something new. This should cache some values in the memory to speed the image generation, and then the model goes to the K-sampler. The workflow below in this template does not have the node for the main image. So this is a text-to-image workflow, where the generation will be affected by the reference image we upload. In the above workflow, if you bypass these nodes, then it should become a similar text-to-image workflow. The model used here is the FP8 model, which works on my 4060 Ti 16GB card. However, this video is for users with a smaller graphics card. I will create a duplicate workflow for the GGUF model and add the links here to the GGUF files, clip encoder, and VAE. These GGUF files are not a checkpoint, containing clip and VAE, so we need to download those separately. These are the GGUF models, starting from 4GB in size. Next, you need the clip L file and this T5 encoder. Third is this VAE file. The remaining files are the same in their respective folders. These are the three nodes to load the files and replace these three connections. I have made the connections for GGUF models, and it should work now. I will upload an image, and first, I will try without any reference image. I will bypass these and generate. My prompt is, the girl is riding a bike on a street. Somehow, the empty latent had a size of 3,000 pixels. I fixed it and tried again. The result looks good. The girl is matching the image I uploaded. The few images I generated takes around 55 seconds on average. Maybe a LoRA could help. This 8-step LoRA should work. This should speed up the generation a bit. I have added the link to the LoRA. I will duplicate the node and select the LoRA. Then decrease the generation steps and queue the workflow. It took 52 seconds on the first attempt. And then in the second attempt, it took 40 seconds. That saves around 15 seconds. My prompt was, the women in coffee shops carefully looking out the window, conveying beautiful emotions and blessings. Only the main image was uploaded. No reference image was used. These are not cherry-picked. You will get few bad images with these LoRA model combination. My prompt was, in a wool style, a watch and a pile of sweaters. The text here got changed. The prompt was about a wooden watch lying on the ground. I brought the reference image nodes to see how it works. My prompt was a woman made of straw, cinematic photography. The image is not bad. It took the style from the cat made of straws. No prompt was used here, and the style was referred by the given image. But I was expecting it to be more strongly influenced. The Pixar style mouse worked as well, especially their eyes. Now I will try bypassing the main image, and will be using the reference image only. These nodes make the condition for the image I upload. Now my prompt will be the only condition to generate. My prompt is, a mouse is sitting on a chair. The only thing I don't like here is the fingers. The image looks great, filled with details. I should be able to get the style from some of the older LoRA, based on stable diffusion models, with the power of the Flux model using just an image. Using the LoRA image as a condition, this is the result. I combined a simple pencil sketch with a famous Vincent van Gogh's painting as the style reference, and the result looked like something Van Gogh himself might have created. This PNG image gave an unexpected result. It reminds me of website designs by some top-tier UI designers. I personally think this was the best. Playing around with PNG gave some unexpected results. I took these results one step further with the Wan 2.2 5 billion model. As you can see, I have uploaded both the before and after image in this workflow. And my prompt is, the speeding sports car turns into a flat color image, time-lapse photography. The iteration is fast because I'm using a smaller 5GB model, and the Sage Attention patch as well. I will link the video to set up Sage Attention. Make sure to use it if you want to speed up your Wan video generation. After 105 seconds, I got the result. This 5 billion model actually is not for fast motion video, but it gives decent results when there is less motion. Let's look at the workflow quickly. Both the before and after image goes to the start and end image connections here. These are the nodes for the GGUF models. And you can use these nodes if you are not a GGUF user. I have used a LoRA as well, and the Sage Attention node. The rest should be common to you. I have added the links to the models. These are all the GGUF models you can choose from. Starting from 2GB size. The largest is 5GB in size. This is the model used in the video with a direct download link. Similarly, the text encoder and GGUF encoder, the VAE and the LoRA file. You can also use the entire workflow here and connect the before and after images directly. You will also need something in between to generate prompts automatically. I will try this. Stay connected in Discord for such topics. I will try upgrading the workflow and post here.